Welcome back to the channel. This is Wei Hao at Direct Impact Solutions. If we look back on new features introduced to FileMaker in the last 5 years and try to pick one that has the biggest impact, many people will choose the ability to specify curl options for the insert from URL script step. Why? From the solutions perspective, it means all third-party web services that have web APIs are now potential extensions to our own FileMaker solutions, which greatly expand what our solution can do. From the developer's perspective, with this feature, we can confidently say yes to almost all web integration requests that our clients give us, and deliver them across the entire product line, including WebDirect and FileMaker Go. However, doing web integration is not that straightforward, especially if you haven't done it before. That's why we're creating a new series of videos attempting to create practical guides on common tasks that you will run into when doing a web integration. In these videos, I will focus on one small task at a time. If you don't understand every single concept in the video, that's fine. Some of them will be explained by later videos, others I would encourage you to Google them yourself. Each video will have a demo file available for download, and each video will have an assignment at the end, asking you to do some hands-on work. The goal is to give you something to bring into your solution while getting you comfortable with web integration work. When integrating with a web service, the first thing it asks you is to authenticate. And the simplest scheme of authentication is called Basic Authentication. It essentially asks you to provide your username and password so that it can grant you access. Basic authentication is quite common. In fact, FileMaker's own admin API on FileMaker server uses it. So, in this video, let's use FileMaker admin API on FileMaker server as an example to construct our very first HTTP call to do a basic authentication. Before we dive into coding, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss our weekly content. To start integration work with a web service, we cannot get around reading its documentation because each web service is unique. For me, I'm calling a FileMaker server installed on my computer. So the URL to the API document is this. If you're calling a server that is not local, then simply replace the host name with the actual host address. I know this looks like a lot of information, but don't get intimidated. As we build our script, I will point out key information here and show you how to use that in our script. So step one, we need to know where to send the request. This is like writing the mailing address on your letter. The admin API reference is actually pretty convenient for that. If you click on this dropdown right here, it will actually build the endpoint URL for you. So I will copy this and paste that into the endpoint field so that later on my script can grab this value for the call. I will talk more about endpoint URLs in future videos. So now that I know where my request would go, let's work on the curl options. So curl options are information we provide to the receiver of our request to help interpret and process our request. Think about it like things we write on the envelope of our letter to help get the letter delivered and understood. For basic authentication, we need to specify four options. The first option is to tell the web service what kind of request we're making. In this case, the documentation actually tells me this is going to be a post request. So in my in my calculation, the very first option, I'll just put dash dash request space post in here. The second option, we need to tell the web service what kind of content it should expect to receive. Again, going back to the documentation, it tells me the content type is application/JSON. So that is going to be what I am going to put here. And then for the third option, we use it to specify where to find the data carried by the request. This is an option that accompanies almost all post requests. For now, let me just put this here, and we'll explain that in future videos. And the last option, which is also the most important one, this is where we actually specify the username and password so that we can get authenticated. Here, I'm using the user option right here with the username and password that we retrieve from two fields we have in the system, and put a quote around them and pass that to as a parameter to the user option. You've probably seen this syntax as well, using the header option instead of the user option, and then do a authorization basic followed by a base64 encoded string that was based upon the username and password. This one also works, except this is a more generic syntax that uses the header option instead of the user option. The reason I prefer this one is just because this is much more concise. The user option actually does the base64 encoding for you. So essentially this translates into this, but it just reads nicer. So we have our curl options. The next step is to actually use insert from URL script step to make the call. So here, for the target, I'm going to choose a field to store the result. Then the URL, we're going to use the endpoint URL that we extracted from this field, which we copy and pasted the endpoint URL from the documentation. Then for the curl options, we already put all the curl options in this variable. So all we need to do is specify that variable in here. And then add a little bit of error trapping in here, making sure that the error trapping result gets stored in the proper place. Now let's give this a try. So if I click this button, which calls the script we just showed, it will give us the response. So what this gives you is a token, which is like a key card that you can use to access the API in all your follow-up requests. So that's enough about the demo. Here's the assignment. Use this demo file as a starter to create your own HTTP call to do a basic authentication with a different web service. The most accessible one might be the FileMaker data API for one of your hosted files. But of course, if you want to do integration with a different web service that also uses basic authentication, feel free to use that too. The goal here is to help you get familiar with constructing HTTP calls in FileMaker in general and get a bit more comfortable with reading API documentation. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.